Because divine worship is the highest activity a human being can encounter, can undertake. And it should be done with the greatest degree of excellence.
At the end of the colloquium, everyone is always surprised that he or she has accomplished that. How could I have done that? How did it happen that we had a, you know, Misa Quartitoni by Victoria? I never thought I would be able to sing a mass like that. I've never sung a mass like that before. How is it possible?
It was during the communion that I actually started, it was almost to the verge of tears. Not so much because of the music, because I felt inadequate. I felt this weight on me. You know, Lord, I can't do this. This is too much. And then I heard this voice say, remember the story of Moses in the burning bush. Moses was the same way. You know, Lord, I can't lead your people out of Egypt. You know, I can't speak. I can't do this. And God said, I will be with you. That's something that's always stuck with me, is remembering that in all of this, God's going to be with us. It's a slow, painful process, and in all that, He knows what we're doing. I think He appreciates our efforts.
I was trying to explain how wonderful it was, and I was explaining it to someone who thought it was kind of a bureaucratic conference, like people were talking about policy or music policy. I said, no, it's people who love music. They're all these singers, and they said, oh, they're excited about it? I said, oh, yeah. And I was trying to explain. I said, look, it's like Catholic Woodstock
for
Gregorian chant people. And he goes, really? I said, oh, yeah. I said, these hundreds of people who are just on fire for this stuff. They're singing. They're talking about it in the lunchroom. It's like Woodstock for Gregorian chant.
Yeah, that's a good analogy. Yeah.
And but it's a genuine labor of love.
Right. It's always a positive agenda. Yeah. Always looking forward.
Always.
And being hopeful.
That's the key. And our organ
I think
is
that's
being
our cue right there.